get what you missed on.
Pearl in the Morning with Tina and Zuki.
And Danko.
We've been carrying a baby with us that came via email through someone who was completely shattered by their family,
right,
who said, listen, I want to cut off my family. I want to cut my brother out of my life because it's hurting my faith and self-esteem.
Mm-hmm.
And they said they wanted to know our opinion on taking bad influences like their brother out of their life,
mm-hmm,
and whether they're going to be a bad person for wanting just to do that and how they can get past the whole ordeal.
Right, right.
And Duncan and I were just speaking, you know, as the song was playing, that this could be about, this is not about you and him, you and your brother.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I think this is about God. You're probably going to ask, what? You know, it's possible the brother is going to change.
Yes.
Because there's no situation that is permanent.
Mm-hmm.
But God may be using this situation to work on you.
Yes.
Ouch. Yes.
Yeah. Ganini, you are the subject.
Exactly.
Oof.
And God sometimes uses the weirdest of situations or circumstances to work on you.
Mm.
You don't have to be afraid about that.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to panic about that as well. But you must remember the prodigal son?
Mm-hmm.
It was never about, you know, him going away or him coming back.
Mm-hmm.
This is a lesson for you to understand. We must master a lot of courage,
mm-hmm,
to remember people like the prodigal son, the tax, mm-hmm, collector, mm-hmm, the prostitute. It's called grace.
Right.
There was grace and mercy for them.
Mm.
Could we show a little grace and mercy for your brother? As much as bad influences might,
yes,
affect you.
Yes.
You,
yes,
know? And it's gonna require a lot of strength on your behalf.
Mm.
Mm. One day your brother is gonna remember your patience. He will,
mm-hmm,
if you're patient. He'll remember your graciousness, if you're,
mm-hmm,
gracious. He'll remember your mercy, if you're merciful. But if he does not recognize that,
mm-hmm,
you will recognize that,
mm-hmm,
and God will too. So pray hard.
Mm-hmm.
Pray hard about what God is doing right now.
Right.
Your family is a bit crazy, and that's fine. But family matters to God. Family is on the heart of God completely.
Mm-hmm.
Even the young lady who told us that, you know, she sent us a message, said they moved back to Kenya and they moved to another city in Kenya.
Yes.
And the dad got a job somewhere else.
Mm.
And they had to move in with their biological mom.
Mm-hmm.
But you cut off your mom for the sake of your emotional and mental health.
That's right.
God can heal that. Then what's left? What's left?
What's left?
You know? And none of the children speak with the mother. This, mm-hmm, is your mother. This is your mother.
Mm.
It hurts, I know. We get there and parents sometimes can, they're trying to put things together. That's the best way they know to parent.
Mm.
But when it comes to cutting off family,
mm-hmm,
you got to ask yourself where the rain started beating you at.
Yeah.
And ask yourself these very hard questions,
yeah,
and don't feel bad about it. People change.
Yes.
People change.
Yes, they do.
So it's in this season where,
mm,
you teach them something.
Right.
Because after they change, they're going to look up to you,
mm-hmm,
and say, had you not been merciful, where would I be today? Had you not been hard on me and patient with me,
mm-hmm,
as I was driving you up the wall, across the ceiling, down the other wall?
Right.
Where would I be? Where would I be?
Jesus, if you gave up on me, where would I be today? With my hard-headedness, with my sin, my folly, everything that I have done to irk you, everything I have done to be away from you and the desires of my flesh, where would I be? Lord, I'm asking you to bless my brother,
mm-hmm,
my mother, my auntie, my uncle, blood,
mm-hmm,
that we don't see eye to eye. Why? Like that email we have received, someone has challenged their faith negatively.
Hmm.
And they have made them dwindle into low self-esteem. There are so many people right now, Lord, mm-hmm, that have siblings like that. Maybe they're drunkards. They're the estate drunks.
Mm.
They're the estate thugs.
Mm-hmm.
They're in jail.
Mm-hmm.
They have trashed their family name through mud and through anything that is evil. And we don't know where to start from. We just want to cut them off. But Lord, even as we step aside, we will not get up from our knees, mm-hmm. will not allow the enemy mm-hmm. to cause us to forget them or pray for them. That no matter what they have done, just like Tina said, it's just but a season. We can't wait for that season
to
when
end.
They finally, when it finally ends and yeah. they get to know you.
Yes.
Ah, Lord. And those that don't see eye to eye because of disagreements,
mm-hmm.
because maybe your sister slept with your husband, because your brother stole your money, because your mother ignored you and decided to be the most toxic person in your life. Lord, heal those wounds.
Heal them, God.
Heal them. Heal them. There's nothing more we can do, Lord.
Yeah.
But just offer all these challenges and all these issues unto you. We place them at your feet because it's the high place, Lord. Because by ourselves, we can't handle it. We mm-hmm. can't, Lord. We can't.
And we know the Lord's heart is with family right now.
Yeah.
So listen, your brother, your sister is not so much an enemy on a battlefield as they are like a self-selected slave on a minefield.
Right.
Of course, you know it is not your job to rescue them.
Right.
But I believe beyond belief that one day their life will run dry and you will be the beacon of hope that has always been there. So,
that's right.
In the meantime, it'll be up to you to examine your own heart.
Right.
Grow in humility
and
wait on God. It will get better. I can't see it getting better now, but it will in the end. Don't let the enemy win this one.
That's right.
Okay? Don't let the enemy win this one.
That's right.
Join Tina and Zuki and Danko on Pearl in the Morning.
Weekdays from 5:30 a.m. to 10 a.m.